G'day everyone. I'm here at the Eureka Hamilton charging site, and today seems to be a pretty popular day because it's the last day that the chargers are going to be free before they turn on the pricing, and that's for the whole Queensland Electric Superhighway. So I thought I'd take this opportunity to have a closer look at the pricing for Queensland and more closely Brisbane. All right, well, there's a fair bit to get through, so I'm going to try and fire out this as quick as possible. But primarily in this video, I want to concentrate on the Kona and the Tesla Model 3 performance and how quickly they charge. And we're going to have a bit closer look at how much their costs are going to be. But to start with, the Eureka charging as of tomorrow, the 28th of January 2020, is going to be 20 cents a kilowatt hour. Now, I don't know how they've come up with this price, but that's a fantastic price, and that appears to be even cheaper than what you can normally buy power for at your home. So I think they're going to be pretty popular, those chargers. The only real people that are going to be charging cheaper than that are going to be the people that are using their solar at home, and if you're going to include loss of feed-in tariff. So that's a really good price. They are expanding their network up the Queensland coast, and if you have a look at where their chargers currently are, they will start to put one in between each of the ones that currently exist in probably the major towns, I think you'll find. And that network's going to be really good for anyone who wants to travel up the east coast of Australia, and in particular Queensland. So just on a bit of a paper napkin type of situation, we're trying to work out how much it'll actually cost to travel from Brisbane to Cairns. It's 1681 kilometers. Now I've worked out that the between the Model 3 and the Kona, they roughly use about the same amount of energy per 100 kilometres. And if you take out the fact that you start on 100% before you leave, I calculated that you're going to need around about 200 kilowatt hours to actually get to Cairns. So at 20 cents a kilowatt hour, that's only 40 bucks. Now, if you want to compare that to what a petrol car or diesel car might look at. Now, electric cars are less efficient at higher speed, so petrol cars do tend to be geared for more economy on the highway. But if you look at a car that's using around about 6 litres per 100 on the highway, that would use 101 litres of fuel, and at $1.50 per litre, you're looking at $151.50 to drive from Brisbane to Cairns, as opposed to using the Eureka network for 20 cents a kilowatt hour and only having to pay 40 cents. So that's a fantastic comparison. And I'm not sure how they've come up with that pricing, but I'm more than happy to use their charges at 20 cents a kilowatt hour. So moving on, we'll have a look at, so ChargeFox were really the first ones to establish themselves with the 350s. They put them in at Toombul. We still don't have any other 350s from them in Queensland. But their pricing model has pretty much always been 40 cents a kilowatt hour. They do have a 50 kilowatt charger that is at Toombul. And I'm not sure what's going to happen with the pricing there, seeing as Hamilton is so close, and I would expect that they'll keep it in line with the other 350s, but it's going to be a bit strange situation. Why would you use that charger when you can just pop down the road and use the 50 kilowatt for 20 cents a kilowatt hour? But because they've built the Queensland Electric Superhighway, there's less less infrastructure going to be built by the companies like ChargeFox and Eevee up the coast. So we might be limited in that sense to just the 50 kilowatt chargers, but they're fine. So we're waiting to see what's going to happen with ChargeFox for the moment. I'm not entirely convinced that they're going to stay at 40 cents a kilowatt hour. But moving on, we'll go to Eevee. Now, their pricing model has copped a lot of flack, and they are charging 35 cents a kilowatt hour. But in the interest of moving people along and not having slower vehicles hog a very fast, high-powered charger, they've added the 25 cents a kilowatt hour as well, 25 cents per minute on top of the 35 cents per kilowatt hour. And so here on these charts, the Kona is going to be charged around about 56, 50 cents a kilowatt hour if they do a fairly long charge. But if they stay a bit longer, that's going to be up around the 60 cent mark. Whereas the Model 3, because they have such a high charging speed, they're only really going to be charged around about 45 cents. And because it keeps charging faster and it's still fast at the end of their curve, so they're not really going to see much of 50 cents a kilowatt hour. So before they brought in their pricing, it was anticipated that the EV pricing would be around about 60 cents a kilowatt hour. I think most people thought that was, you know, that's what the assumption was, and that's therefore you know, that's what was expected. But a lot of slower charging cars aren't able to charge there without a large penalty, and that's where a lot of the problems come from. But as far as the Tesla community is concerned, I can't see them having any problem at all with having to pay 45 cents a kilowatt hour to 50 cents a kilowatt hour, because you have to remember these chargers are designed for highway long distance charging. They're not the local charging stop where like the some of the 50 kilowatts are located around the place. These are pop in, have a quick bite to eat or a coffee, your car's charged in 20 minutes to half an hour, and then you're back on the road and you're gone. So with that in mind, that's how they've priced their model, and I can't really see that 60 cents a kilowatt hour is that much to complain about when you're doing a long distance trip. How does the Kona and the Model 3 compare if they were going to charge on the EV network, if there was a theoretical one that went to Cairns for that same trip? Well, I crunched some numbers again, and it would look like the Kona would cost around about $114 to get to Cairns, and the Model 3 would cost around about $91. Now, just remember, you're getting higher speed. Your trip is potentially going to be quite a lot shorter if you've got this higher 350 kilowatt speed available. Obviously, depending on how fast your car can charge, but the 50 kilowatt network's going to be limiting by the charger, not the car. So you could potentially save a couple of hours when you're on a drive to Cairns by having that extra speed, but it's going to cost a bit more. As of only just recently, the QUT University on the Hurston campus, they've put in a charger at one of their parking facilities, and essentially the cost of the charging is free. On a 50 kilowatt charger, except you have to pay for parking, which is $5 an hour most of the time. So $5 for the first hour, 2 to 3 hours, 1 hour to 2 hours is $10. So how does that compare for a Kona? Well, in 1 hour, you can put in around about 57 kilowatt hours, which is nearly, you know, that's 80% of your charge at least. So for $5, you're putting in 57 kilowatt hours. That's on the 20 cent kilowatt basis that you're getting for the Eureka network. That's $10, and so you're only paying $5 at the parking stop. So I think that might be a popular option too. As for the Model 3, well, for $5, you're going to be able to charge from 10% to 95% and still have time left over to leave before the hour mark. So I reckon that charger is going to see a lot of business. Lastly, the AC charging. In most cases, this is still free. You've got places like Chermside Shopping Centre, they've got Charge Point, Carindale, other Westfields. They seem to be with Charge Point, but they're the Type 1 plugs, and a lot of those cars are starting to get on a bit. So the standard seems to be heading a lot more towards Type 2 charging, and but a lot of those chargers seem to be free. There's the occasional EV link one, like there is at Toombul as well, where you have to bring your own cable, and they're free still as well. So very interesting. A lot of charging prices at the moment. So just a quick roundup, we've got Eureka 20 cents a kilowatt hour. We've got ChargeFox 40 cents a kilowatt hour still. Maybe there'll be an announcement, I'm not sure about that. EV are looking at around about 45 cents to 60 cents a kilowatt hour. You've got the QUT parking, which is just $5 flat rate for as much as you can fill in 1 hour, $10 if you're there for more than 1 hour. So very good pricing. And I hope that's all kind of made sense. There's more to come in this space, I feel, as the more infrastructure gets rolled out. But I'll do another update maybe in 6 months' time when we get some more info. But I hope you've enjoyed that one, and I'll catch you on the next one.